Here we want to demonstrate how to use the Peng-Robinson equation state spreadsheet that solves this cubic equation state to calculate the fugacity for a single component. And the fugacity is important when we're looking at vapor-liquid equilibrium, but it also indicates how far we are from an ideal gas by how much the fugacity, in this case, differs from the pressure. So what we're given is the temperature and the molar volume. So we have to find the pressure that corresponds to these two conditions using the spreadsheet. And then the spreadsheet also simultaneously calculates the fugacity. We'll use solver in the spreadsheet to iterate to get the pressure. So now let's go and look at this spreadsheet. So here is the Peng-Robinson equation state spreadsheet from the Elliott and Lira textbook. And I've taken a couple liberties of reducing the number of significant figures displayed and making the values we're interested in highlighted. And so what we want to do is, first, we need the critical pressure and temperature and eccentric factor, because those tell how non-ideal the system is by using reduced values in the equation. And so spreadsheet has a page where we can look up these values. If we scroll up, we can see this is critical temperature, pressure, and eccentric factor arranged in the same way. And so I can just copy these values and paste them into the pressure, volume, temperature. And then I need to put in the temperature of 40 C in Kelvin. And it then, for a pressure of 1/10 of megapascal, it calculates the volume. Well, this is much bigger than the volume of 220 cubic centimeters per mole that is given in the problem. So we need to adjust the pressure. Clearly, the pressure needs to be higher to make the volume smaller. Notice we're in the one root region of the cubic equation state. No guarantee we'll stay in that one root region as we increase the pressure. But, for example, as I increase the pressure, I can see the volume decreases. And so I can use solver to very quickly get an answer. If I go into solver and indicate the cell that I want to adjust, and that cell then is the volume. So I'm going to select this cell, and I want it to be equal to 220. And then what I'm going to do is change the pressure cell. And this is left over from a previous, so let's remove this. And now if I select solve, the solver comes up, says it's found the solution. Here's the pressure in megapascal, so it's about 69 bar pressure to get this volume. So the spreadsheet is a very quick way solving the cubic equation of state.